الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله وما التوفيق ولا اعتماد إلا على الله عليه توكلت وإليه أنيب أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا نظير له ولا مثيل له شهادة موصلة إلى دار القرار ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمد عبده وحبيبه ورسوله وصلى الله تعالى رحمة العالمين صلى الله تعالى علي وعلى آلي وأولادي وأصحابي وأتباعي وخلفاء الراشدين المهديين من بعده وأمزراء الكاملين في عهد خصوصا من على الأئمة خلفاء رسول الله على التحقيق ومرأي المؤمنين حضرة أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي القدر الجليل وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين يا أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون اتقوا الله تعالى واطيعون إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه المنزل على نبيه المرسل بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين آمنا بالله صدق الله مولانا العظيم وبلغ رسوله الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين قال رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم إنما الأعمال بالنيات صدق رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم أو كما قال All praise be to Allah Almighty the most merciful the most beneficent May endless peace and blessings of Allah be upon His beloved Prophet Sayyidina Muhammadin sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam sent as a mercy for all creation. May endless peace and blessings of Allah be upon his blessed family, his companions and all those who follow his guidance, his ways, his sunnahs up to the eternity. All believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calling upon us through the Holy Quran. Kunu ma'as-sadiqin. Ordering us to be in the company of sincere ones. Because to be among the sincere ones is important. Because in the Day of Judgment, the ones you have been companioning here for Allah's sake, if they are from the people of Paradise, they will be interceding for you. Because Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, mentioning through the Holy Hadith, that يُحْشَرُ الْمَرْءُ مَعَ مَنْ أَحَبَّهُ People will be raised in the Day of Judgment with those they love. If they love the sincere ones, they will be raised with the sincere ones. And their character and akhlaq will be reflected and changed, because they will be like mirrors for us. They will be helping us to improve ourselves, to check our mistakes, to make ourselves look like them. Even if we are not like them, the good company will bring goodness and barakah and blessings for us. To be with the Sadiqeen is important, because we are followers, lovers, believers of Sadiq al-Wa'd al-Ameen, the Prophet and Messenger who has been sent as a mercy for all creation, and he was recognized even by Quraysh non-believers before even he received revelations, the Holy Quran, as Sadiq al-Wa'd al-Ameen, the sincere one and most trusted one, and the one who keeping the promise. This is a characteristic of the believer. And the benefits of being sincere explained through the Holy Hadith that Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam mentioning that the sincerity leading to good deeds, good deeds leading to paradise, and the opposite, the one who is not sincere, who is lying leading to bad deeds, and bad deeds ending you with bad ending in the hellfire. And Prophet ﷺ mentioning that somebody who will be sincere and continuing to be sincere and speaking the truth and being truthful until that point when his actions translated and acting according to what pleasing Allah, there will be a moment he will order angels to put the name of that servant in the books of obedient servants from the Sadiqeen, among the sincere ones. Then from that point he is guaranteed that he cannot leave anymore the path. He will be protected up to the end, because he make the habit part of his life, part of his attitude, part of his character to be sincere in every situation. Then that sincerity leading to successes in everything he does, because Allah looking at the hearts of the people before actions. Maybe for people, actions can be the ways we judge, but Allah is looking at the intentions in the heart before actions, because certain actions may be for us perfect, but no value in Allah's sight. In the Day of Judgment, there will be three categories of people. One, they standing to be judged. Everyone will think they are from the people of paradise because of their good actions, good deeds. First will be the alim, the knowledgeable one. Everyone will think, oh, he is a great alim, great scholar. But when he is judged, Allah will order to be taken to the hellfire. The reason is that his ilm did not benefit him. He benefited others, but not for Allah's sake. His intention was to be praised among the people that he is a great scholar, he is great alim. And people said that all of them. Then he got the reward from this dunya. Nothing left for him for akhirah in the Day of Judgment. Also, the generous person who is known to people, he giving without limits, and he also will be taken to the hellfire. And the reason that he did not do this for intention of pleasing Allah, but his intention was for people to praise him, he is a generous person, and to be known as a generous, as a kind person. Then his benefit was already granted through this life in dunya from people. He received the title of being the generous person, Then nothing for him in Akhirah. And the third one, he sacrificed his life in the way through the battlefield, known as a shaheed amongst the people, brave. But he did for the reason not to please Allah and not to protect the believers and sacrifice for the sake of raising the word of Allah and protecting the deen of Allah and weak ones, but to be mentioned among the people that he is a hero. He is a brave one. He is a strong one. When people already mentioned that, then he has nothing in the Day of Judgment to receive from Allah Almighty. O believers, let's check our hearts. Let's check our intentions before our actions. Let's think before saying anything. Because our tongue also can be means of reaching to highest honorable stations in the sight of Allah, and also can be the main reason for why most of the people will end in destruction in dunya and akhirah. War, maybe, for us looks like nothing. But war is everything. The way you say and the intention you have behind. If you are saying a good word, what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about the good word, kalimatu tayyiba, sadaqa. Why is sadaqa? You are not giving anything, but this would be sadaqa jariya also, because you are advising somebody, you're making somebody happy, you're helping somebody, and you taking the worries and taking the sadness, then big reward for you. Even just by the word. But also the word can lead to destruction, to hurting others, also to cheating and lying. And all this destroys your good deeds and destroys the life of people around you, because you are spreading poison without even doing anything. How many people ending because of the fitness starting from the war? It's not from actions. Because Prophet sallallahu ta'ala wasallam warning us as believers, take care of the fitness. Al-fitnatu na'ima. La'ana Allahu man iqadaha. Sadaqa Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam aw kama qal. The fitness are in the sleep, the mode of sleeping. They are everywhere, especially in the end of the time. In every step you move, there are potential of big fitness which can lead to destruction of your good deeds and your actions, and also could destroy the lives of others and your akhirah also. This is why in akhirah zaman we have to be very careful before we say anything. Because Prophet ﷺ saying, fitness are na'ima, they are asleep, and cursed ones are those who are waking up the fitnah. Who are those who are waking up? How do you wake up a fitnah? Fitnah is na'imah. When I say something about my brother, bad, nothing yet happened, because my brother haven't heard. But next person to me, he heard me saying this about my brother. Up to the point when next person who heard this bad word from me, not going to pass that to the person I mentioned in a bad way, the fitna is na'im, nothing will happen. But who is going to wake up? The person who heard this word and passed to that person, then no, is waken up. It means that person is going to react, and his reaction will be also to say something bad or take revenge and go and fight. And this is what shaitan wants. People to be in trouble, to be in fitna, to be in fighting, to be in hatred, to destroy their faith. Because believer cannot be a real believer, mu'min. It's very easy to be a Muslim. One shahada makes you a Muslim. But to be real believer is لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. You cannot be a real believer until and unless you love for your brother what you love for your son. Then how can a believer hate or hurt? Because shaitan wants us to be hurt. wants to be angry, wants to be upset, and wants us to be in conflict with one another, to lose dunya and akhirah, and to be cursed like him. Because Prophet ﷺ said, cursed is the one who is waking up the fitna. Because fitna is asleep. Everywhere nowadays. In our mobile phones, so many messages. If you're passing this, immediately bringing sadness, hurting, and bringing troubles between families, between wife and husband, between children and parents. And this is the biggest game and be the biggest aim for the shaitan is to interfere between wife and husband, children and parents, brothers and sisters, and neighbors. Because if you don't have a peace in your family, in your house, then where are you going to find the peace? This is the big aim to destroy the family, to destroy the unity. Once you have no peace in the family, in the house, then you cannot find that in the street. This is where teachings, guidance, words of Sayyidina Rasulullah and the orders of Allah through the Holy Quran, وَكُونُوا مَا صَادِقِينَ are treasures. If we value and we just follow one of them, will be enough for us to be finding a real peace and happiness through this life and for eternity. كُونُوا مَا صَادِقِينَ. Be sincere. Take only this word, this verse is enough for us to succeed for here and hereafter, for eternity, and to reach the highest honorable stations like the Sahaba they reached. Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq, why he's called Siddiq? Because he was Sadiq, a Siddiq, faithful, truthful, trustworthy, never having any doubts in anything Allah and His Messenger ordering us. Sayyidina Umar same, Sayyidina Uthman same, Sayyidina Ali same, all Khulafa'u Rashidin, teaching all the Ummah, all the mankind how to be real believers. And this is why Allah granted through such a short period of time during their rule for Islam to spread through East and West and for miracles to happen. Well, Sayyidina Umar in Medina, delivering khutbah in Jum'ah, standing in Minbar, all of a sudden he's stopping his khutbah and calling upon one of the companions who was 1,000 miles away from Medina Munawwara. He was in Persia. Saria, he was commanding the Muslim army in Persia. And he's calling, Ya Sariyat al-Jabal al-Jabal. And people looking, saying, what's going on with Sayyidina Umar? He's shouting to a person, run towards the mountain. And that person is not here, he's in Persia. Sayyidina Saria, hearing, listening to the words of Sayyidina Umar from Medina Munawar and asking the army to move towards the mountain because they were trapped by the enemy. If they were not to go to the mountain, they would have been destroyed. This is the Iman al-Haqiqi, the real faith, the real siddh, the real sincerity leading for believers, Allah to give them such visions, such powers, such wisdoms, such knowledge to be able to save themselves and save believers when they're even in far distances. This is what is called known as karama. Allah giving you honor because you are trustworthy. You are worth of being honored because you're keeping the honor for Allah's sake and taking care for the believers. And this is why when the Saria came back, they asked, the companions asked him, what's happened? He said, I heard Sayyidina Umar calling and I ordered the army to go to the mountain and we were saved. And Allah granting for them, for the whole Persian Empire, which no one could take over throughout the history, from beginning to the end, to be taken over by the commander of the Muslim army and in the time of Sayyidina Umar, and from that time to end of the time, never to go back to the olden days where no one could have changed them. They become believers, they become Muslims. And first of them to represent in the presence of Sayyidina Rasulullah was Sayyidina Salman al-Farisi. And Prophet said about him, Salman minna al bayt. Salman is from us, from my family. To be from closest people to Prophet ﷺ is not necessarily to be grandchild or relating to Sayyidatina Fatima to Zahra or Sayyidatina Khadija al-Kubra, the mother of the believers. No! The relationship is with the love and obedience and following the ways and sunnah of Sayyidina Rasulullah. This is why he is from Persia but become part of the family. This is Islam. This is Iman. This is sincerity. This is the way we can save ourselves. Even following one of the orders, it will be enough for us through the barakah of this obedience, of following this order, of being sincere one, to be entering our names in the book of the sincere ones and be protected through this life and for eternity. But if we, following the ways of shaitan, because he's the biggest liar, and we're lying and cheating and doing bad actions, the moment will come when Allah says and orders angels, put the name of that disobedient servant, arrogant one, that liar in the books of liars, and they will end bad ending. These are the situations which we have to be taking care for ourselves, taking care for our tongues, taking care for our actions, what we are doing. Is this pleasing Allah Almighty or pleasing our egos or pleasing our enemy? Number one enemy from the day one when Adam alayhi salam, Allah raised him to the station higher than angels and asking angels to make sajda. He's refusing, saying, I'm better than him. And he become number one enemy. And he was there cheating and lying, trying to take him from the highest honorable position to take him out of paradise. But he didn't lose that, because immediately when he make a mistake, he didn't become arrogant like that one who is cursed, Iblis, but he immediately said, La ilaha. He asking, Rabbana zalamna anfusana fa in lam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lanakunanna min al-khasirin. Ya Rabbi, if you don't show your mercy to me, to us, and forgive us, we will be from the losers. Immediately showing humbleness, and Allah granting him, bestowing upon him the position of being most honorable among the all creation. May Allah grant us to be among the sincere ones, forgive our sins, keep us in the right path, and keep us in the istiqamah and ta'ah and obedience to Allah and the ways of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ameen, ameen. Wa sallallahu ala Sayyidina al-awwaleen wal-akhirin wa habibi rabbil alameen wa shafi'i al-munnibin Sayyidina Muhammad al-Nabiyy al-Ummi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Ala inna ahsan al-kalam wa laga nizam kalam Allah al-Malik al-Aziz al-Allam kama qala Allah tabarak wa ta'ala fi ahsan al-kalam إذا أقرأ القرآن فاستمعوا له واصفوا لعلكم ترحمون. صدق الله العظيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله الحمد الكريم والصلاة والسلام على رسولنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. تعظيما للنبي وتكريما لإقامة شأن صفي قالها عز وجل قال مخبرا وآمرا بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى سيدنا محمد كما صليت وسلمت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك في العالمين حميد مجيد. آمين. اللهم صل وارحمنا واسقنا وغيثنا واشفينا واشفي مرضانا وارحم مرضانا واصلح شاننا وشان المسلمين وانصرنا على الكافرين والظالمين الطاغين. اللهم اكفر أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم اشف أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم احفظ أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم انصر أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا أرحم الراحمين ارحمنا. يا أرحم الراحمين ارفع أقدامنا. يا أرحم الراحمين يا غفار الذنوب يا ستار العيوب يا فتاح القلوب. اللهم اسكنا لبيتك وسكي رحمته ولا تجعلنا من الخاطئين. رب اغفر وارحم وانت ارحم الراحمين. والسلام على المرسلين واخر دعوانا ان الحمد لله رب العالمين. اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. ولذكر الله اكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. اقيموا الصلاه.